Hello. In this tutorial, you will learn how to convert photos into a pixel art effect in Photoshop. Also, you can use the same technique to convert vector shapes to pixel art like this. Let's get started. After opening your image, grab any selection tool and start selecting your object. You don't have to make a precise selection. In my case, I use the quick selection tool. After completing your selection, select your main layer, then press Ctrl plus J to take what you have selected to a new layer. Now, the cup is in a separate layer. With the cup layer selected, go to Filter, Pixelate, and choose Mosaic Filter. Add the cell size. This is to determine how big the pixels will be. In this case, I will keep my value at 25. Please remember this value. We will need it later. Now, press Ctrl plus J to duplicate your layer 2 times. Select all 3 layers, then, right-click and choose Merge Layers. Now, hold the Ctrl key, then, click on the layer thumbnail to make selection. This is to select the opaque pixels and neglect the very transparent ones. Now, create a mask from your selection. Now, I need to make these areas completely solid, not transparent. With your layer selected, press Ctrl plus J to duplicate it 6 times. If you still have transparent areas like this, you can create a new fill color layer below. Choose a gray color. Then click OK. Delete the layer mask. Hold Ctrl key, then click on a mask thumbnail to load the selection. Now, select the fill layer, then click on the mask icon. Now hold Shift, then click on the first layer to select them all. Right-click and choose Convert to Smart Object. Great! Let's create the pixels grid. First, go and check your image resolution. From image size, you can find it here. In my case, the resolution is 72. Just remember this value. Now, create a new document. Add the cell size in both width and height. Make sure to choose pixels. And change resolution to your main image resolution, which is 72 in my case. With this little document, we will make a pattern to help us in creating the pixel grid. Press Ctrl plus 0 to zoom in. Double-click the layer to unlock it. Then, double-click again to open the layer style. Now, click on Stroke, then create a 1-pixel stroke with inside position and black color. Then click OK. Make fill 0 to leave the stroke only and hide the background. From defined pattern, you can make a pattern from this stroke. Give it a name and click OK. Now, get back to your main document. Select the effect layer, then press Ctrl plus J to duplicate it. Double-click that duplicated layer, then choose Pattern Overlay. Choose the pattern that you made. And keep the other values like this. As you can see, the pattern fits the pixel squares very well. Now, make fill 0 to keep only the grid visible. Right-click it and choose Rasterize Layer Style. Now, we have the grid on a separate layer. Double-click the grid layer to open Layer Style. Click on Drop Shadow. Then, add these values. This will add a 1 pixel depth to the grid, and give us a great effect. You can control the shadow opacity as you like. Also, you can decrease the all layer opacity from here. 30% will do great for me. Select both layers and drag to group them. Now, go and create a hue and saturation layer. Clip mask it. Then change saturation to 20%. That's it. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please don't forget to like the video. And subscribe for more tutorials. Thanks for watching.